Hello, this is Janne Immonen and Rob Q-Day. Today I just speak what is the coming to my mind. And now I'm here in Pattaya Beach, Thailand, to do in my morning walk. And few days ago, I didn't feel that I want to go morning walk anymore. So I was thinking, but what was the issue? And I was knowing that when I walking over there, sometimes there is like lots of dirty and some garbages are out there, so the feeling is not the best because I wanna like get fresh air, but there was lots of other things ongoing over there. So then one day I was thinking about, okay, let's go to beach walk. And then I found out that when I started walking without shoes, it just feels so great. So I make there like small change. And sometimes also in Finland that when I'm doing the morning walk, okay, I don't want to go there. But it helped very much when I make my preparation, I do everything ready there, and then I just go. That I don't need to think about where I'm going. And sometimes you need to just take different route than normally. Just looking around, see what is going on, what is happening. Many times I will check myself about the buildings, how everything is there. Maybe I get some new ideas and that kind of things. And of course, I can also see if there is some real estate for sale, because that is also very interesting. Look, there is lots of boats, so many boats. Speedboats, and those are going very fast, and I think there is some island that they are going, I don't know if you can see, it's over there, but anyhow, morning walk is so great way to start your day. And many times I do some different techniques over here, some breathing, exercise, focusing my walking, thinking what I want, do some affirmation, whatever comes to my mind. But of course it's good to start thinking those before you go. Because one thing why I go to morning walk is that it's like meditate. That we want, I want to reduce my thinking, that it's keep my thinking calm down and it's calm me down. And that's why it's also so great way to start the day. Because of course in these days there is so much everything, emails, phone calls, all the electric things, what is going on around there. To check in those all the time, so that's why it's very important, like get connected to yourself, that you can feel cool. Remember also breathing this amazing fresh air every day. And I know some people say that I don't want fresh air, and I think you can't find fresh air any place. Only need to think about it, fresh air, if nothing else is helping. But if you are thinking that it's not fresh air, it's not fresh air then, but it's everything come to here. And also about your mindset, how you are thinking, how you are seeing the life, it's affecting so much for everything. So when something's happening, are you like victim that, oh, why this has happened to me, or are you just calm down and start to think about what you can do about this. And sometimes even my flight have been so much late, then I have started to think about what is the reason that I'm still here. And I have found some answers, and those have been so great days, one of my greatest days, because I have asked what is the reason behind that I'm still here, that my flight is not leaving. You can find answer many ways and many times, but you need to ask questions for yourself and just listen to answer. Don't try to answer yourself, just listen what is coming over there, Sometimes this might sound very strange, but trust me, it's very good to try, because I know I have used these techniques many times. But check. Today I'm going out also swimming over there. I have my swimming stuff with me. And like always, I didn't wanna go to swim so often, but I think I understand this trip that I don't wanna go many times swim for daytime. Because many times there is so many people, there is so hot in outside. So now I'm going to morning swim. And this is very great. Now I think it's maybe 6:30 or something. I have done lots of training already this morning. And this morning walking the beach is one exercise. And finally when I have done this, I go on the sea for a few minutes, maybe 5 minutes. Swim, relaxing over there. And it's just so great feeling. And because you can do that. Of course, in the Finland situation is different. I'm coming back also Finland in a couple days. Yes, I'm coming tomorrow. I'm coming tomorrow over there. And honestly, I need to say that I don't know if I want to come, because many things is so difficult in the Finland. Because the system is designed other way. Because in Finland system is designed that you need to do all the work yourself, that it's not good to hire anybody, that you need to work yourself. But that's not right. You need to also learn to outsource everything you can, all the daily activities like cleaning, some if you have need to do something outside, don't do those yourself. You need to use that time for better, like reading a book, checking videos like this, making some business plan, some strategic thinking, maybe going to gym. And I also know many people say, hey, if I'm doing those outwork there, it's like going to gym, but you are lying yourself. It's not, it's like hard work. And sometimes those works, trust me, it's better. Left somebody else also. I outsource my laundry, cleaning, and I hope that I can outsource like my food store. And it's also important that outsourcing, it's not meaning in the food that you are going to eat outside. Because many times it's not good, because that food, it's not so healthy. And there is coming so many extra things that I have studied that so much, and every time I eating some bad things, my energy levels drop, so maybe my muscles go to very like pain, or at least very tight. So be very careful what you are eating. I prefer very simple food, very natural food, bio food, not any processed food, and study a little bit what you are eating. And I know it's not easy. Hello, it's not so easy just change your diet plan or what you are eating, and you need to do that step by step. And when I start changing my eating, I had once time per week I have cheat day. So every Saturday I eat everything that I want. And that works, because I remember in that time I was going to pizza, kebab, I was eating ice cream, I go to McDonald's, eat cheeseburgers. But when I eat so many cheeseburgers, then I understand I could eat this anymore, and these days I can't eat those anymore. So it's working very well, but you need some time there, give some time for you. Just, you can even start in the breakfast. Make your breakfast yourself, make it very good. Or if you go in the, for example, hotel breakfast, check what you are eating there. Many times some hotels, even the omelette is not like real omelette. They put in maybe milk there, they put some other stuff. They might make that omelette in the powder. So you need to see that it's like real egg. And there is nothing extra there. And of course it's much better, it's bio egg. So if it's like some heavy industry eggs, it's not good for you. And people say that cholesterol, I can't eat eggs because there is coming cholesterol. But I have eaten eggs, I don't know even how many years, probably 5-10 years. I have eaten so many eggs every day and my cholesterol values are so good. But like in these days, now I have changed my diet that eating now like a little bit different way in the morning, but not, this is just for testing phase. I try to eat more green stuff, and maybe a little bit less, because all days I was just eating so much in the morning, and that was basically very crazy. And now I reduce my eating, and of course we need to focus quality food, because when we are eating quality food, we don't need to eat so much. Because when you are going to fast food, ready-made foods, there is coming so much something that you don't need and what is not good for you. That's why you need to just eating. But when you are eating very poor fresh food, you don't need to eat so much. And even it sounds that it's more expensive, but maybe in real life, that when you start to eat less, you don't need to eat so much. And then you are saving the money. And then, of course, it's not anymore so expensive things. Okay, pizza is ending. Now it's my time to go back over there. This is, what was the name? Beer Garden, that is excellent place. You can go there and sit top of the sea. There is great breakfast also, and some good Thai food. If you are here, go to see there and check there. But remember, maybe once per day in the outside. Yeah, I have also seen that it's much better to go like real store and buy there some fresh food, bio food, and just cook for yourself. It's much better. Oh, this is just so great to be here walking over there in this amazing beach. And like I say, tomorrow I'm going home. It's otherwise very nice and otherwise it's very sad, because I just like to be here, because everything is just working here. I can just go outside, I can just put my hand up and I get to drive there. There is so many like motorcycle, bike, taxis, normal taxis, so you don't need to think about how you travel. You just go outside and you can go anywhere you want, very cheap price. And that's just something, it's good. And what I also like so much is there that people are really working here, because in here there is not any social security system, and if you are not producing, you don't get any money. And I think we need to learn this from here, that we can bring it for Finland. Because Finland, we have this social money there, and people are staying home, they are crying that they don't have job, they can't do anything. But I have seen also myself that people are saying no for work. For like myself, I have many employers, and I have seen many times that we have work, but it's not full-time work, and people say no. That how that's possible? They are unemployment, they are staying home, and when we offer work, they say no. I only come if it's full time. And then it's very crazy that there is coming many like cases. Okay, I want to do only this one, nothing else. And I do only full time, not any part time. And think about how this can be work. That you are home, you don't have work. And then you have work, but it's not full time, so you say no. So you never want a job, but if you take this one job, there is coming opportunities. Hey, this person is working very well. Why we give try for these other things that maybe you can do? And also, if you are one place working, then people asking, hey, I need some services. Then you are there, you can say, hey, I can come to work also for you. And very soon you will see, hey, I have job. But that is something different because now I'm working for so many different persons. And many times we think about that, that's too risky, that's too dangerous. But think about if you have 5 or 10 clients and you are working for 10 and one is leaving, what is happening? Nothing is happening to you because you have so many clients. You just find new clients over there. But if you have just one, if you have just one client and some reason that is ending, you are trouble. You are trouble because you need to find out where you find new one. But like Finland, we are so lucky that we can stay home. But I don't know really is that so lucky that we can stay home and be lazy. Lazy over there and crying just ourselves that I don't have job. Because it's like real life, it's our responsibility that we need to work, we need to do that, that we will want a job. And if there is not that kind of job that we can do, it's your fault, it's your fault. And what you can do, then you need to educate yourself, you need to study. And not just stay home and think about I don't have job. And many times world is changing, jobs are changing. And if you have been 5 years and you have done nothing, what do you think about that you can do in these days, what you have done 5 years ago? And then it's very difficult for you. But that's why study every single day and think about what you want to do. And don't be just for after the money, because the money is coming. Many times I have earning so much money, but I have starting everything again and start to do new things. I don't recommend that for everybody, but before you do that, you need to have some plan that how you will get the money, what you are going to do. Otherwise, it's not so good situation for you. If money is not coming there and you are panic, but what I can do, what should I do? So best way, if you have some work, you can start to create your second flow of income. And that second flow of income, it's your bridge for your next venture. What you going to do when you are big man or big lady? And that is like bridge theory. Now look. Not seeing so good, but so many birds is sleeping over there. But just think about that. Creating second flow. Don't quit the first one. It's every time better if you are creating second and third flow and you can keep the first flow. But sometimes if the second flow is enough, then you can quit the first one, but I don't recommend that one. So keep the first flow so long you just can and just make the second and maybe third flow working and you start to produce more money and you start to notice your freedom. Because you start to be free, because you are not depending anymore in one place or one idea. Look at that. This is so great views over here. So think about all of these ones. This was, I think, my longest video in this moment, and I hope you enjoying for this video. Put some comments over there, what do you think? Remember to like this, go also Instagram to follow my page over there, and remember subscribe for YouTube channel, and then you can see more of Rock You Day videos, and you can start to take steps for your dreams and your visions, and you can start to push yourself every single day, and you can start to live Rock You Day life. Thank you so many, and I hope you enjoy and have a nice day. Rock You Day.